today I'm going to be doing a video on how to make some DIY Polaroid pictures. The problem with Polaroid pictures is that number one, they're really expensive, and number two, you only get one shot at taking a picture. So with these DIY Polaroids, all we're doing is taking existing pictures that you took with your phone, camera, or anything like that, and making them into a Polaroid form, or making them look similar to Polaroids at least. So if you guys would like to see how I created these DIY Polaroids, then just keep on watching. So what you're going to need is some acrylic coating and some spray glue. I got both of these at Michael's Craft Store. And also a paper cutter or some scissors and a ruler. And lastly, some pictures and some cardstock. So the first thing that I'm going to be doing is editing my photos. You definitely don't have to do this step, but I just like to give my photos a more vintage feel. As you can see, some of these pictures I took directly from my Instagram, so I won't be touching those. But for the ones that aren't edited, I will be using an app called Pixlr or Pixlr. I don't know how you say it, but basically it's an app that I got from the App Store for my Mac computer. It's completely free, so if you guys have a Mac computer, then feel free to download it. I will leave a link to it down below in the description box. And if you guys don't have a Mac computer, I don't know any for Windows, but I do know of a really good online editing software, and it's called picmonkey.com, so I will leave a link to that down below in the description box as well. What I like to do is just play around with the filters and see which ones I like best, and once I'm completely done editing the photo, I will save it to my computer. So now we're going to create a collage with all the photos that we just edited, and you want this to be a JPEG image that is the size of the paper that we will be printing out the pictures on. So I will be using Microsoft Word for this part of making the Polaroid pictures, and I will tell you why in just a second. So the first thing you want to do is just make sure that your Word document is the size of the print. In this case, mine is going to be an 8x10 print, so I want to make sure that the Word document is 8x10. Then you're going to insert a photo, and you're going to select picture from file, and then just find the picture that you want to put into your document and select it, and then it'll end up like this, and then now we just want to resize it. And this is why I like using Microsoft Word, because it shows you the dimensions of the photo in inches when you resize it. And this is really important because all the dimensions that I'm going to give you are in inches and not pixels, as opposed to using like Photoshop or something. So now I'm using this one, or this photo, for a 600 film photo, and basically what you need is a square. So the size of it is supposed to be a 3x3. One tip is to make the photo a little bigger than it should be, just so that you have a little bit of slack when you're cutting them. And also, all the sizes for the photos will be down in the description box below. Then once you're done with resizing it, you're going to go to the top right corner and click wrap text, and it's a picture of a little dog, and you're going to click the one that says tight. And what this allows you to do is to move the pictures freely amongst the page. A lot of times when you don't do that, Word documents won't allow you to do that. So like you'll see in this next one, I'm just basically resizing it to a 3x3 because that's the size of the picture that I want. And I'm clicking the wrap text, clicking tight. And then it allows us to move the photo wherever we need to. And as you can see in a second, I changed the format from a portrait to a landscape form, just so that I could fit more pictures. So if you need to do that, then feel free to do so. And then once you have all of your photos in your little collage form, then you're just gonna click File, Save As, and you're gonna save this Word document as a PDF file. Sometimes places like Kinko's let you bring in a PDF file, but the place that I went to, which was Office Depot, doesn't take PDFs. So when I open my PDF, I'm going to export this as a JPEG file, and most places will take JPEG images. So click JPEG and then click Save, and then there you go. You basically have your JPEG file. These are my two collages that I have, and now all I need to do is just print them out. And I printed out my pictures for like $1.60 for both sheets at Office Depot, but you can print them out at home if you want to. And next, you're going to cut out the borders and the photos. And I'm taking my printed photos and I'm just roughly cutting around the edges of it. And I will use my paper cutter to make sure that the lines are straight, or my cuts are straight, sorry. So I am going to be cutting this photo out as a 3x3 photo because I'm using it as a 600 film Polaroid picture. And once I am done cutting it out, I will show you what it looks like. and it should look like this. This next photo is a wide photo, so I am giving it, or I'm cutting it to the dimensions of what a wide photo is supposed to be, and like I said, all the dimensions will be down in the description box. So if you're just using scissors and a ruler for this part, it is going to be a little bit more difficult and a little bit more time consuming. So what you're going to do is just trace a box around the picture with the dimensions that I give you below. But honestly, this paper cutter was like $15 at Office Depot and they always have coupons. So if you wanted to invest in one, definitely get one because it will really, really help with this project. So now what I'm doing is just cutting out the border. I'm making little dots where the corners of the border is supposed to be, and roughly cutting around it, and then using my paper cutter to make some straight lines. And then once you're done cutting the border, this is exactly what it should look like with the picture in it. And then once you have all of your borders cut out and your pictures cut out, then we are going to go outside and glue them. Make sure you go outside for this step because it will stink up your house with some fumes that you do not want to be breathing in. And what you're going to do is just take a photo and spray the back of it with some spray glue, and then taking the photo and lining it up on the border. The best guideline that I can give you is leave a quarter inch at the top and then just make sure there's an even amount of border on the sides. And I like using these little penny saver ads to spray glue on because all you need to do is just flip the page and then you can glue another photo without it getting stuck to the paper. So you're going to do the same thing, just glue it. And for every single photo, no matter what size it is, no matter what Polaroid you're doing, you always want to leave a quarter inch at the top and then just make sure there's an even amount of border on the sides. Then what you're going to do is take the crystal clear acrylic sealer, I guess you can call it, and then just spray a nice layer onto each of your Polaroid photos. This will just keep it looking new for a lot longer. And then once you're done spraying it, you definitely want to let these dry inside because you don't want your pictures flying everywhere when it's outside and it's windy. So once you are done spraying all of your photos, let them dry for a good 30 minutes to an hour just to be on the safe side, and you're pretty much done. So thumbs up if you guys enjoyed watching this video, and if you guys do try out this DIY, definitely show me your pictures and hashtag createADIY just so that I can see your pictures and like them and all that good stuff. I am on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat, so go follow me on there if you'd like. And if you want to see my, well, this isn't really my previous video, but if you want to see my fall makeup tutorial, then just click on that little video right there. I love you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!